So the title is A Man of Science, so an old-fashioned term which is was used commonly in the 19th century, later replaced by scientists, simply scientists. But I think this is a better way to describe a real passion, love for chemistry, determination to explore new fields, and so on. And LLG, our jubilee is known to friends and co-workers under the initials, and I think it's practical, and I will use the initials instead of Lechosław Latos Grażyński, which will save a few seconds every time, so a few minutes of the whole talk, I think. Yeah, so, well, have you ever thought about our human life as a collection of periods, like a periodic tale? Well, I found this concept and I was very proud of myself, but later I was disappointed that I was not the first one. but still, I think it's nice, and I will use it throughout the lecture. So the first period is very short, it's early childhood, you do not remember anything from this. Then you are a child, a teenager in period number three, which ends with, well, so atomic number, of course, represents an age. Yeah, so 18, it's at least in Poland, the legal age of you start to being adult, and so on and so on. So the whole period, whole periodic table now ends at element 118. So it's more or less the limit of human life. So I think it's a nice analogy. You can find yourself, your age here, and find what element you represent, or you can find your element and find your real age. So we are found on boron. You are really five. So 70 is just a middle of period number six. Yeah, 17 elements before and 17 after, just between 70 and 71. So we are here in the center of sixth period of life. Everything started 70 years ago, a bit more, in Szczecin. It's a city on the west part of Poland, close to the German border, and it's a part of so-called recovered territories or lands, so regained lands. Simply after the Second World War, Poland shifted a bit to the west, and we got some new lands, which well were treated as regained after many centuries. And there was a politics of the authorities to populate the lands. So it's this event which is mentioned here is a part of this politics, and I think it was a good idea. Well, we can gather here because of this. I'm showing the postcards from this time, which illustrates my castle in Szczecin, here called Zamek Piastowski. So it attributed to the first Polish dynasty. Well, they never reside here, so it's not true, but again, it's part of this politics showing the roots of Polish roots of Szczecin. Now it looks a bit different. Okay, we move to this. Okay, not yet. I was always curious whom I'm sharing the birthday with. So you can see several persons who also were born earlier or later, maybe recognize some of them. Well, let me introduce. The first is Bronisław Malinowski, so a scientist, Adolf Dymszaj, Polish actor, Francis Ford Coppola, Gerhard Schroeder, Jackie Chan, Mark Brzeziński, new ambassador of USA in Poland, Russell Crowe, Wayne Roberts, actors, American actors, Frank Ribery, football player, and Sylwia Grzeszczak, Polish singer. Yeah, so let's continue this early childhood. I share with you a secret, that in fact the first name of our laureate is Cyril, and we should use a longer acronym, in fact. But he chose to use his second name. I know the reason. Yeah, because you know there are two names which are very important for Poland, and it's just two in one. Let and Jarosław in one. So I think it's a good idea to have this name and use this name, although it was a bit problematic for some editors. So here you can see better versions maybe, but later I think the problems were no longer valid. Okay, so second period was spent mainly in Żagań. You can see a palace, and the second picture is no longer a palace, but a school, a primary school, which he attended, and then a secondary school, another nice building. He started, of course, as a teenager, and finally finished as a laureate of chemistry Olympiad. So this was a privilege to choose the place to study, study chemistry because of interests. So if you look at the position of Żagań on the map, it's the similar direct distance from four big cities with the universities to in Germany, so Berlin and Dresden, and Poznań and Wrocław in Poland. And well, good for us, the choice was Wrocław. Well, possible cause maybe it was associated with another guy from Żagań, from the same school, secondary school, who a few years earlier started studying chemistry at the University of Wrocław, and now he's a retired professor of our university, Professor Henryk Kozłowski. Some of you know him. So, at certain sense, our hero followed his footsteps in Wrocław, in the new building built for the university, for Faculty of Institute of Chemistry, University of Wrocław. Well, it was about 50 years ago, so now it's a monument treated in a special way, but then it was modern. And a very important person who built this institute, well, maybe not with own hands, but her concepts, very powerful woman in chemistry, especially coordination chemistry, so Jarosław Szygatowska. LLG started studies in her working on resonance of some complex, and what was very special for Poland, paramagnetic complex studied with NMR. So LLG was one of the pioneers of paramagnetic NMR in Poland in general. Yeah. Photos from his diploma when he finished studies and started PhD studies under the same supervision. One additional photo, but my colleague said that LLG is similar to Woody Allen. His sense of humor is also similar. So okay, not this one. LLG was hired also at the Institute of Chemistry, starting work together with working on PhD, and again PhD was about, the thesis was about nuclear magnetic resonance applied for paramagnetic systems, quite complex equilibria, pH dependent, so quite advanced chemistry. Equipment which was not so advanced at this time. I can see also a friend of LLG, regrettably passed away, Dr. Krzysztof Drabo. The promotion of PhD You may recognize one more person who is in the audience, Dr. Ludmila Sternberg, Dr. Andrzej Ożarowski, who gave a speak today, So, yeah, also promoted at the same day. Yeah, and then allergy started next stage of work at university, but shortly he found a nice place for internship to practice with paramagnetic NMR with professors Lamar and Alan Bach, whom we had the opportunity to listen to yesterday. Davis, so a few pictures were shown yesterday as well. So Gert Lamar, Alan Bosch, and one more this time. Yeah, and this is a bit later picture, but it's Alan Bosch as well, and his coworkers. Yeah, and as Daniel mentioned, he decided to come back to Poland to build his own research group later, he had opportunities to return to Davis many times. So altogether, it was I found this somewhere 54 months spent in Davis altogether. And first publications from this time, and first publications on porphyrins of LOG in JAX with Alan Bach, Gert Lamar, and Rujen Chang, whom he cooperated with at this time. Yeah, and we come to the middle age. So when he started his independent position at the university, first as associate professor, then with a professor's title, and our group, so metalloporphyrin chemistry research group, later renamed slightly, also started as a small team of workers. You can see some of them, some of them were present here. Professor Jerzy Lisowski in the first slide, Professor Piotr Chmielewski, Dr. Ludmila Sternberg, Dr. Krystyna Rachlewicz, Professor Stanisław Wołowiec, Dr. Ewa Pacholska-Dudziak, and myself as well. And the group grew up. More and more people. There are some extra persons in this photo, but we extended a bit, gaining new laboratories as well. Conditions of work improved. Also the international position of the group also is getting better and better. I don't intend to show much chemistry, as there were a lot of chemistry during the symposium, so just a quick glance at some research lines at this time. But I must stop here. At this abstract from the conference, which was held in Karpacz in June 1993, and you can recognize the shape of inverted porphyrin, visible this title maybe of the abstract, so let me read this: coordination properties of Polish porphyrin. Why Polish porphyrin? Not because of patriotic reasons, but rather by analogy to so-called Polish mag. In the US they have jokes about Polish people not very intelligent. So a special mark which are used by Polish people in the US. So an analogy of this to this mark was used. Of course, this was not accepted internationally. So maybe there is a Japanese mark as well. So we can find another name. inverted porphyrin and also expanded porphyrins started to be a new idea, new concept, new driving force for the chemistry in the group. So many new macrocycles were obtained, well, some of them shown here, extending the concept of aromaticity, switching aromaticity from HECO to Möbius, and so on and so on. Organometallic chemistry as well. So, well, many possibilities. Okay, we are at the current period, senior years is the time when we have, and you have the position, you have your habits, good and bad habits, you have your favorite class, as you can see. Yeah, see, very nice shirt. I'm not sure that it's the same shirt, but. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Let's mention this pupils. So up to now, LLG supervised 17 PhD students. The pictures are shown, and well, you can meet most of them here. Most of them simply remained at the University of Wrocław, and some PhD studies are in progress, some almost finished, I think. So we can expect a bit more. I can see the moment of handing the PhD diploma, so a celebration of this. Yeah, and I also wanted to mention collaboration. Some persons whom you could also listen to yesterday. We had Professor Marchand in Wrocław, so we hosted him a few times, and also Professor Balch. This photo was also shown yesterday. Yeah, so the parameters are collected here, so we cannot establish exact number of publications, but the number is not so important. LLG always preferred quality over quantity, so many papers are quite long and worked for many years sometimes to have a really completed research of given subject. Yeah, so therefore we can call LLG as okay, some, so sorry, I forgot about some covers, because well, especially our students, our doctors are good at preparing nice illustrations of the research, and it's quite frequently accepted as a cover. So these are from just 2 years chosen. There are much more. Okay, so I'd like also to mention some awards and honors. Starting from this award, which is sometimes called Polish Nobel Prize, so out of the Foundation of Polish Science, you can see laureates from this year 1998, and also the family, wife and two daughters. Now, I think it's this one is more practical than Swedish Nobel, because of the statuettes. You know, bad guys also read newspapers and get they know that you received a prize, so some money, and when they enter your house, yeah, would you protect with just medal and diploma? Well, statuette is much more practical. I know, so I think so. Okay, so more awards from Polish institutions, Polish Academy of Science. Recognition by Polish scientific community was by election of OG to be a member of Polish Academy of Science. Now he's a president of Wrocław branch in the upper picture. And here he was given an award of Polish Prime Minister, so we can recognize Polish Prime Minister. Can you find our hero? Okay. Right. Right here. I think right here. Yeah. If possible, he avoids a flash. Yeah. You can see all other peoples are quite blank and he is different. Okay. Oh, also some medals. I have never seen him wearing them, but yeah, he also received some medals and also international recognition, which allowed him to visit Germany several times, especially Bremen and Japan, giving lectures. Okay, so. Concluding, yeah, we can. I think we after knowing his contributions, we can call LOG a real master of porphyrins, well, or maybe a king of porphyrins. Yeah, so I found the picture, and well, we have also another version of the crown, especially for those. And one more possibility, maybe a porphyrin pope. Yeah? Why not? Yeah, there are some similarities. Yeah, it's really Pope Francis, quite resembling our professor. Okay, so really to conclude, I think we can wish LLG exploration not only into the seventh period, but non-existing yet eighth period, yeah, because he loves exploring new fields. So let's assume that we can meet again in 50 years to celebrate his 120th birthday, maybe. Okay, thank you. I do not expect any questions. I would like, on behalf of the organizers as well, to thank all of you who gathered together to celebrate this special occasion. All speakers, also virtual speakers, and some persons couldn't join us, but they sent best wishes to the Jubilee. So I would like to mention them. Well, and let me also thank the organizers for preparing this event. So they are not only here, maybe you can show also, some of are in the audience, the persons who prepared the event. So please show up. And well, we of course it's not the end. We want to meet together in a restaurant. Does it change? So the dinner starts at 8 p.m.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's still late as we have a bit late. But okay, so maybe our Jubilee wants to say a few words. Thank you.
The first thing first. No, I really like it. I appreciate Anya's effort.
But see you. Thank you.
The first thing first. I was really surprised. I knew really nothing. Okay, so the very first days was kind of challenging because of that, meeting that many colleagues all over the work, Poland. I prepared actually a kind of presentation, but Jacek did much better job, I could imagine about that. But so I would like just to say thank you for everybody who was involved, everybody who gave a talk, either directly here or over the web, or people who got involved in this. I think we have done this already, so it's fine. So it's kind of difficult. One can get too emotional. I was asked if I'm going to cry. I'm not going to cry, maybe at home, but still, I'm really grateful being here. And not only because of the today's event, but because of all things which happened all over these 40 years with people I had the chance to work, I had the chance to enjoy that talents and sharing. And thank you one more. Thank you very much.